evangelist, the feast. And we pray for the special intention of SPJ parishioners as we join the fathers who are traveling to Africa, that they may have the safe journey. Together with all our particular intentions, we begin our celebration. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You are sent to heal a contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people on good will.
We praise you.
We adore you.
We glorify you.
We give you thanks for your great glory. Glory to God, Heavenly King.
O God,
Almighty Father.
Lord Jesus Christ,
your only begotten Son.
Lord God,
Lamb of God, Son of the Father.
You take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
You take away the sins of the world.
Receive our prayers.
You are seated
at the right hand of the Father.
Have mercy on us.
For you are alone in the world.
You are alone in the world.
You are alone in the Most High Jesus Christ.
With the Holy Spirit.
In the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Lord God, who chose St. Luke to reveal by his preaching and writings the mystery of your love for the poor, grant that those who already glory in your name may persevere as one heart and one soul, and that all nations may merit to see your salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading. Luke is the only one with me. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, Demas, enamored of the present world, deserted me and went to Thessalonica, Crescens to Galatia, and Titus to Dalmatia. Luke is the only one with me. Get Mark and bring him with you, for he is helpful to me in the ministry. I have sent Tychicus to Ephesus. When you come, bring the cloak I left with Carpus in Troas, the papyrus robes, and especially the parchments. Alexander, the coppersmith, did me a great deal of harm. The Lord will repay him according to his deeds. You too, be on guard against him, for he has strongly resisted our preaching. At my first defense, no one appeared on my behalf, but everyone deserted me. May it not be held against them. But the Lord stood by me and gave me strength, so that through me the proclamation might be completed and all the Gentiles might hear it. The word of the Lord.
Amen. Be to God.
Your friends make known, O Lord, the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let our faithful ones bless you. Let them discuss of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might. Your friends make known, O Lord, the glorious splendor of your kingdom, making known to men your might and the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is a kingdom for all ages, and your dominion endures through all generations. Your friends make known, O Lord, the glorious splendor of your kingdom. The Lord is just in all his ways, and holy in all his works. The Lord is near to all who call upon him, to all who call upon him in truth. Your friends make known, O Lord, the glorious splendor of your kingdom.
Person lives there, your peace will rest on him, but if not, it will return to you. Stay in the same house and eat and drink what is offered to you, for the laborer deserves his payment. Do not move about from one house to another. Whatever town you enter and they welcome you, eat what is set before you. Cure the sick in it, and say to them, the kingdom of God is at hand for you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The feast of today, which we honor and celebrate, is a feast of mercy, universal salvation. Luke wrote the Gospel and also the Acts of Apostles, and in his writings, he tried to show God's universal mercy towards the poor and marginalized. And this being the month of October, is the Gospel of Luke where the first chapters talk about Our Lady. He's the patron of medical professionals, artists, painters. He's depicted as the one who painted the Our Lady. Who is this Luke exactly? The evangelist. The gospel says Jesus sent other 72, two by two in pairs. It is said he was among the 72, was the companion of St. Paul. In the first reading, we hear St. Paul is lamenting on his missionary journey, second missionary journeys. All of his friends had abandoned him. They had left him. Those who ate with him, they had left him. Who was there with him? Was Luke. A true friend indeed, in every station of life. Sending two by two, it means we are called to be united in the mission of Christ. Achebe, one of the writers, said, together we stand, divided we fall. The church which stands together, it moves ahead. The family which stands together moves ahead. We are called to be together, to work as a family, bringing Christ to others, touring others. And Jesus wants us. He's sending us like lambs among wolves. Your calling as a Christian is a challenging calling. But God is always with you, as we heard in the first reading. All of his friends abandoned Paul. He was alone in the prison, apart from Luke and Caesar. But God was with him. Never surrender on God. Behind every successful hero or star, there are some leaders, unknown heroes, background workers, non-recognized assistants, who helped for this hero to succeed. Paul is among the successful preachers because Luke was with him. Behind the success of Paul as a preacher and a great evangelizer was this man, Luke, the author of the gospel we are reading, and the Acts of Apostles. This man, Luke, was a great writer and a trained physician. And Paul himself testifies in today's reading. He gives a testimony. Luke was right there with him in prison, looking after the needs of his physical health and assisting him in his mission. From the statement of Luke himself, of St. Paul himself, said, Luke alone is with me. Luke must have also assisted Paul in writing some of his letters. Luke was converted to the faith by St. Paul. This conversion occurred while Luke was treating Paul during an illness on his second missionary journey. According to St. Jerome and St. John Chrysostom, the Gospel of Luke can also be described as Paul's Gospel because he got everything from Paul. Of all the four Gospels, Luke is a winner. When it comes to powerful storytelling, he knows how to articulate things, the facts. In particular, Luke emphasizes Christian purity, poverty, joyfulness. St. Luke employs detailed graphic descriptions in presenting an obsession, the visitation, the birth, and the early life of Jesus. The only person who had the privilege of having one-on-one contact with Our Lady was Luke, and he is the painter of Our Lady. Luke is said to have interviewed Mary when composing his gospel. Luke is credited to have painted this beautiful lady whom we meditate on in this manner. We can ask ourselves, will anyone speak well of me like this after my departure? Or will I be remembered for harming others? In today, again, Jesus said, the harvest is rich, but laborers are few. Today the harvest is rich, but there are few committed laborers. There are many baptized people. There are many brothers and sisters at home there. They don't know even the Lord's Prayer Sunday. They are not committed. It's your responsibility Jesus is sending you today that you go and bring these people back. And in our present world, the emphasis is no longer on solo winning, but on prosperity and freedom. It's my freedom. I do what I want. Rather than pointing fingers at God's ministers or making jokes about bad Christians among us, Jesus is calling you and me today to join the harvest. Harvest good fruits by being members of his family, mentors of faith, hope, and love. The number 70 is symbolic of a large and complete figure. You and me are needed to join hands for the salvation of souls. Luke heard the call and he responded. As a doctor, he treated people. He cured diseases. As evangelists, he fed their souls with God's word. As academician, he wrote brilliant gospel. After researching and interviewing eyewitnesses, what are you going to do today? What are you going to leave as a legacy? We ask the Lord for intercession of St. Luke, that he increase the grace and strength and wisdom in us, that we may bring change, beginning with ourselves. Fed by the word of God, we offer these prayers on behalf of the world, for the church. May God continue to equip her to preach, teach, and love in Jesus' name. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For people throughout the world, may God bless them with leaders who work intelligently for peace and justice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who feel abandoned or alone, may God accompany them in their suffering and provide resources to ease their burden. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For this community of faith, may the Spirit of truth guide and mentor us in building the kingdom of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the faithful departed, may God in his merciful love welcome them home. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all our special prayers and petitions, we present them to the Lord in silence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Father in heaven, grant these prayers according to your gracious will. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept his sacrifice for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his children.
Grant through your heavenly gifts that we may serve you with freedom of heart, we pray, O Lord, so that the offerings we make on the feast day of St. Luke may bring us healing and give us glory. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is too right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, our Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For you have built your church to stand firm on apostolic foundations, to be a lasting sign of your holiness on earth, and offer all humanity your heavenly teaching. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the host of angels, we sing to you with all our hearts, crying out as we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like they do fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to the disciples, saying,
take this, all of you, and eat of it,
for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection,
we offer you, Lord,
the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have made us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring back the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Timothy our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember us, our brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep with the hope of resurrection, and all our heavenly enemies, welcome them to the light of your face. Amasmas, we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary and Mother of God, the blessed Joseph our spouse, Saint Luke and all the apostles, and all the saints of Christ through the ages, we may make to be courteous and to life, and praise the Father of your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us give each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. Grant me, pray, Almighty God, that what we have received from your holy altar may sanctify us and make us strong in the faith of the gospel which St. Luke proclaimed. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters. I want to acknowledge the presence of our two beloved brothers, priests, who came all the way from Ohio, and they are traveling to Tanzania today. It's going to be the first time for Father to go to Africa. I'm sure it's expecting to see a lot of lions, elephants, but you have hope for them. Otherwise, you come back without seeing any. So we want to accompany them in our prayers that the Lord may be with them on the journey they are planning to take. Lord, you fill every place with your presence and lead them on the journey they are planning to take and help them reach their destination and bring them home safely and in good health. May their journey bring a message of hope and a witness to our lives and life, to all they need. Father, grant them a fair weather and a safe journey. In the company of your angels, may they arrive happily at their destination. Lord, guide them on the road they will take. Be with them in their every need, their companion on the journey, refreshment in need, protection from cold and rain, support when tired, encouragement in adversity, strength when the going is hard, and under your guidance, may they arrive happily at their destination and return home safely. This is our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Amen.
And have a blessed day.
You too,
Father. St. Michael,